Until then, keep cranking out these tween fantasy resolutions. They're wildly entertaining. And that's the memo. When Politico asked Speaker Pelosi about Ocasio-Cortez's pet project yesterday, Madam Speaker called it, quote, the Green Dream, or whatever they call it. Pelosi was slightly less dismissive today, saying she welcomes all the enthusiasm. So is the Green New Deal too absurd for even most Democrats? Joining me now, the conservative male AOC, Florida Congressman Matt Gaetz. Welcome back to the show.
Thanks, though I'm not sure that I quite can live up to that moniker. I will say that the green dream sounds more like of a green nightmare to me, when none of us are able to turn on the heat or turn on the air conditioning, when we can't fly, drive, get on trains. I guess we'll all have to just move around on our winged unicorns to get from point A to point B. I tend to fall in line with Sir Winston Churchill, who said that capitalism is the unequal sharing of profits, but socialism is the equal sharing of misery. And that existence sounds pretty miserable to me, Kennedy.
It's socialism. I mean, that's what it is. It is unashamed socialism. They talk about the collective. They talk about redistribution. And the Green New Deal, I described it last night as a blob, because that's what it is. It is. It's an undifferentiated hodgepodge of various programs that are completely untenable. They'd be impossible to get off the ground, and even worse, to try and sustain.
So well, and get rid of good
stuff. These people just trying to become folk heroes? What is going on in Congress?
The main problem we have in Congress is that people are better at branding than legislating. I don't know that most of the people who even support the Green New Deal could tell you what's in it. I mean, it eliminates nuclear energy in this country, one of the cleanest forms of energy we have. And, like, the poor people who struggle month to month to pay their electric bills in cold parts of the country probably are not going to be too thrilled when their electric bills go through the roof and they're unable to sustain themselves. And so, like, these ideas aren't, like, cute and adorable and kind of funny to toss around. They're actually dangerous to people who rely on us to make decisions based on the facts and not just a clever branding strategy.
They're going to bankrupt the country. That's exactly, there's no other way around it. There is no amount of taxation you could ever levy that could pay for these programs ever. And I know they think that that corporations are these giant magical money factories. They believe the same of the Fed. That's simply not how the world works. And when the economy shrinks, which is what will inevitably happen, people die. That's not hyperbole. That is fact.
Absolutely. And I don't think that there's like a total lack of common ground on the question of climate change. I'm a Republican who believes in science. I think the earth is warming and humans contribute to it. But I don't think that we need to unilaterally disarm the American economy to deal with climate change. Let's do what Americans have always done. Embrace innovation. Let's get good ideas to market faster. Let's have people around the world copy our best practices to be cleaner, safer, and stronger. But instead, what this new, like, brand of socialists who've come into the wave of Congress in the midterms wants to do is make Washington the center of all power in American life. I don't tend to think that way. I want to empower the individuals to make better choices, and I don't think it's an either-or decision. You can see the impacts of climate change and have a strategy to address it that embraces what's best about America, not what's worst about Venezuela.
Yeah, absolutely right. And it's interesting because what they won't admit is the earth is cleaner now than it has been, and the free market is providing solutions that people want. How many more electric cars are there now than there were 10 years ago? And that is not because of government mandate. That's because people are growing more sophisticated, and people actually care about things, and the government doesn't have to be the only forceful mechanism that brings about change.
Yeah, if I have to bet on American innovation or the United States Congress, it's not really a fair bet, Kennedy. It's just the best in our country comes when we unlock the potential of our people, not when we try to constrain our people with their big government overlords.
Yeah, and everyone only making $10,000 a year does not sound like a decent proposal to me. Congressman Matt Gaetz, thanks so much for being here.
Thank you, Kennedy.
Well, Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos is accusing the National Enquirer and its publisher of extortion, saying the tabloid is threatening to release naked photos of him. Yeah, FBN's Deirdre Bolton joins us with all the juicy details.
Yep.
Deirdre?
I was going to say, usually I'm talking about